Hello and welcome to Comic Drake, where I talk about comic books. My name is Drake. With Marvel's infinite multiverse, there are of course infinite versions of their many characters, but I think there might be more spider people than pretty much any other character that they have going for them. And I think one of the most well-known and oddly specific versions of Spider-Man is Peter Porker, the Spectacular Spider-Ham, because what's more ridiculous than a literal spider pig? Cue the obvious Simpsons joke.
Spider pig, does whatever a spider pig does.
Today we're going to be taking a look at the complete history of Porker and his entire universe, which are both subjects that I have spent a little too much time researching, but hey, that's my job. Enjoy. Good God, Spider-Ham. I went into researching this video just thinking that it would be a cute and quick topic, but no! Peter Porker is such an old and obscure character that preserving his books wasn't really thought of. That means that I also need to apologize in advance, since only 5 issues have been released digitally so far, which means that some of my scans are going to look lower quality than you're probably used to on my channel. Okay, so the tales of Peter Porker take place on Earth 8311, also known as the Annaverse, where all of your favorite Marvel characters appear as anthropomorphic animals. However, there's people all across the internet who refer to this world as Larval Earth, which isn't a thing. Like, at all. I did some digging, and this comes from Marvel Tales Volume 2, number 230, where Larval Comics is mentioned several times. But here's the thing, that's just the parody of Marvel Comics inside of this animal universe. It's not the name of the reality as a whole. This is just another example of someone incorrectly putting information on a wiki without a source, nobody fact-checking it, and then people repeating it all across the internet who also don't bother to fact-check it. Ham-fisted nerd rage aside, Spider-Ham and his universe first appeared in Marvel Tales No. 1, that's Tales Like the Animal Body Part, in 1983. But this one-shot proved to be so popular that it spun out into an ongoing series. Alongside Spider-Ham, we saw other animal-based heroes in the form of Captain Americat, Goose Rider, and the less creatively named Hulk Bunny. But hey, this is the history of Spider-Ham, so back to him. Contrary to what you might have thought, Peter Porker actually started off as an anthropomorphic spider who lived in the basement of a brilliant scientist named May Porker. Her latest invention was an atomic-powered hairdryer, but when turning it on, it just caused May to become mindless and irradiated. Acting on her base instincts, May bit the spider and passed out. However, this bite caused Peter to mutate into a pig. Although he was now the inhabitor of a new hog body, Peter still retained the proportional strength and agility of a spider, along with the ability to wall crawl. After a frightful outing around town, Peter returned home and discovered May, awake and delusional. Miss Porker was under the impression that Peter was her nephew, so the spider pig just rolled with it and adopted her last name, fully becoming Peter Porker. It also turns out that Peter absorbed May's scientific genius during the transformation, and he invented web shooters to make up for the loss of his ability to do so as a spider. With all of this, he decided to become the Spectacular Spider-Ham. No Uncle Ben, no power and responsibility speech. From here, a lot of Peter's life is a little bit confusing since we don't follow his life per se. Instead, Spider-Ham stories almost exclusively revolve around Peter's misadventures with J. Jonah Jackal and the other employees that he works with at the Daily Beagle. The only other break to the formula was when May introduced Peter to Mary Jane Water Buffalo. The two started dating rather quickly, and when not palling around with the Daily Beagle crew, Spider-Ham stories tend to consist of heroics getting in the way of their dates. After 17 issues though, the Spider-Ham series ended, but that didn't mean the end of Peter Porker or the Annaverse. From time to time, Spider-Ham would be released as side stories in the Marvel Tales series, which is fitting considering that he got his start in a parody of it in the first place. He'd also make occasional appearances in the comedy anthology series called What The?, but by the early 90s, Peter Porker and his animal-filled world were largely forgotten by Marvel, only really serving as reference material from time to time. All of this would change though in 2014 with the release of the massive crossover event, Spider-Verse, where spider people from all across the multiverse came together to fight the Inheritors, who are interdimensional vampires who feed off of the energy of spider totems. That's a whole concept that's weird, complicated, and warrants a video all on its own. Spider-Ham mostly existed in Spider-Verse for characters to go, "Is that a talking pig?" But he also acted as one of the main faces of the event's marketing. It makes sense considering just how wacky a concept of a spider pig is in comparison to the other humanoid characters. It's kind of surprising that Spider-Ham didn't do more though, considering that he appears to run on cartoon physics, even when outside of his universe. He can take large amounts of damage without being hurt, he can survive being flattened by a mech, and he's even been seen to produce a tornado so powerful that he could send an entire robot army through a rip in the space-time continuum just by spinning his arm. Jeez, and here I thought that the Captain Universe Spider-Man was the most overpowered of the bunch. Since returning to the spotlight in Spider-Verse, Spider-Ham has popped up in a lot of recent comics. Pretty much any time that universe hopping is involved, regardless of who is doing it, you can expect to see him and or Earth 8311 for at least a second. That's why it's not surprising that following the events of Spider-Verse, Porker and some of the other Spider-Folk formed a team called the Web Warriors, whose job is to patrol the universes that lost their Spider-Defenders during the events of Spider-Verse. Although it was a short run, Web Warriors was a fun read, especially for the character interactions, with it actually spending more time on Peter Porker as a character than any other book since his ongoing series back in 83. Really though, that's all there is to the character of Spider-Ham, but while I have you here, there is a lot of information about Earth 8311 that I think is worth mentioning, but didn't really have a place in the history rundown. So first up, the Antiverse has its own version of the Ultimate and 2099 universes, complete with their own Spider-Hams. The stand-in for Miles Morales, Miles Morhamis, is especially funny, with him taking up the mantle of Spider-Ham after his world's Peter Porker was killed by the Green Gobbler. I will say though, the artwork in the book that he was introduced in is just plain unsettling. Another fun tidbit is that there is a pig version of Venom in the Antiverse called Pork Grind. He showed up for literally one issue of What The, but was able to have an official Build-A-Figure released of him. We did briefly get a Spider-Ham in the black suit though, when it was randomly given to him by the Bee Yonder. Oh, here's another fun one. In an early issue of Spider-Ham, we're shown that non-anthropomorphic animals do in fact exist in the Antiverse, but after this, they're never seen or mentioned again. Decades later, we learn that the universe is surrounded by an anthropomorphic field that gives animals sentience. Even a normal animal brought there from another universe will naturally become anthropomorphic over time. What's even more interesting is that Porker is shown to be fine with eating meat, including pork, in other universes, since he sees himself as a higher life form than the non-sentient animals. Okay, how about this? Earth 8311 doesn't focus strictly on featuring animal versions of Marvel characters. It's even gone out of the way to feature such parodies as Woodchuck Morris and Batmouse. Last one up, although it's a different universe entirely from the world of Marvel's Zombies, the adventures of Spider-Ham kind of predicted the creation of the popular spin-off series. Honestly, if you get a chance, then reading some of these old comics are a lot of fun, with a lot of crazy random tidbits. Although OG Spider-Ham comics are silly and frankly ridiculous, I feel like there's a lot of storytelling potential that is left untapped. I think if a new writer came in and played with it kind of like the Batman Lil Gotham series, Marvel might just have an all-ages hit ready to go. I love me some Spider-Ham, but by only making him a silly joke and as reference material, they are literally wasting a universe of possibilities. But if you like this video, then why not consider subscribing, or even watching another one? And if you like alternate universe spider people, then why not check out the video I did on the Japanese Sentai Spider-Man? It is frankly one of my favorite videos that I've ever done on the channel, so maybe give that a watch. But anyway, I hope you learned at least a little something new, and hopefully, I'll see you next time.